Hello, and thank you for tuning in today. I'm Caitlin Ray.
And I'm Sarah Jo. The fall semester has gotten off to a great start, and SGA welcomes students back with a full week of fun activities. Keep it here. 7 News starts now.
NWTV7. NWSU students attend the annual Howdy Week to kick off for the fall semester. I got to join in on the excitement. Take a look.
Northwestern recently welcomed back students for the 2016 fall semester. The Student Government Association sponsored the event Howdy Week, getting students involved and out of their dorms during the first week of classes.
Is our welcoming events week. We started the week on Monday with Aloha Northwestern, and Tuesday we have movie night, and Thursday we have a walk party, Wednesday is a big town red, is a scavenger hunt throughout the community, and then Friday we're getting
Hope there's the last event of Howdy Week, so we can do a lot on Aloha, social media.
Make sure to check the Northwestern website for more upcoming events. I'm Katie Hart, reporting for NWTV7.
Looks like the students had a lot of fun. A big thank you to SGA for all of their hard work. Northwestern's homecoming is set for September 29th, 30th, and October 1st. The entry float and sketch are due Wednesday, September 28th. The forms must be turned into the Office of Student Services in the Fine Arts Building, Room 126. The theme for the 2016 homecoming is Rangers, League of Heroes. The floats will participate in the parade located in downtown Alva at 10 a.m. Saturday, October 1st. For more information, contact Richmond Adams at 580-327-8428.
For college kids on a budget, organizations on Northwestern campus offers free meals throughout the week. Here's a look at what is available.
Up next, Cooper Stanley will give us a look at Ranger Sports. Keep it here. We'll be right back.
The Ranger football team started the year off with a thrilling victory over the University of Arkansas Monticello. The Rangers won the game 59-56 with quarterback Reed Miller throwing for 7 touchdowns against the Weevils, breaking not only his own record, but Northwestern's record for single touchdown pass in a game as well, also breaking the Great American Conference record for single touchdown passes in a game. Not only did Miller do that, but he was also named Player of the Week for the Great American Conference. However, it wasn't only Miller with an outstanding performance. Also big plays by running back Anthony Cota, racking up a total of 94 yards and a touchdown score for the Rangers, as well as Horatio Smith with 130 yards with 2 scores on 3 receptions. The Rangers dominated most of the game, up by 28 points after 3 quarters. However, when the Weevils answered back in the fourth quarter, tying the game up with just minutes left on the clock, the Rangers marched down the field and with just 3 seconds left kicked a game-winning field goal that sealed the victory for the Rangers. The Rangers look to bring their record to 2-0 next week when they square off against the University of Southern Arkansas. The Rangers soccer team played their home opener against non-conference opponent Northeastern State. the ladies unfortunately came up short by a final score of 5-0 for the Riverhawks. Individual efforts by Holly Pancake with 3 shots on net for the Rangers, and also Brianna Legaspi with 8 saves weren't enough to stop the Riverhawk offense. With the loss, the Rangers fall to 0-2 on the season, but look to get a 1 in the win column on Friday at Washburn. The Ranger volleyball team headed to the Aggie Invitational this past weekend at Oklahoma Panhandle State University. The ladies had a tough go at the Invitational where they dropped all 4 games they played in, however lost 2 of the 3 games by 3-2. The Rangers dropped the opener to Texas Permian Basin, the second game to Fort Hays State on the first day, and Missouri Southern State as well as the University of Colorado at Colorado Springs on the second day. The Rangers look to get back on the right track with a win against Newman tonight in Wichita. The Northwestern Rodeo has had a lot of success, but one couple in particular has found more than just love in the arena.
Two Northwestern Rodeo athletes quickly gained the Power Couple title at the College National Finals Rodeo. Shayna Miller won the first round of the goat tying event at the CNFR. Following Shayna's stellar performance, her boyfriend Bryson Seacrest also won the first round of the calf roping event. The couple has been rodeoing their whole life, which Shayna sees as a benefit.
We were both pretty successful. We both held our own and got back to the short round pretty high. And our short rounds kind of fell apart, but it was cool that we both made it that far. And there's a lot of kids that wish that they were in our position. And I just feel like we were good for each other at that point, and I kind of carried him, and he kind of carried me. And
Bryson is traveling the world rodeoing for the Professional Cowboys Rodeo Association, and has been gone for quite some time.
Not getting to see each other is pretty hard. He's going to fly me out there a couple times, but it just didn't work out, and I'm busy with school and my rodeoing, and he's gone a lot.
The next two rounds and the short round at the College National Finals Rodeo weren't as great of results as the round one for the couple. Miller and Seacrest are still known as the power couple to this day. Keep up with NWTV7 to follow the couple on their pro rodeo careers.
For more information about the Northwestern Rodeo team, visit www.riderangersride.com. That's going to do it for sports today. We'll be right back.
Two NWOSU freshman students have received a top honor scholarship award. Oakley Nickel and Capri Gear were awarded the Oklahoma Academic Scholarship Award. The students received the scholarship for 4 years. The award consists of 16 hours paid tuition, free room and board, and $2,000 cash back each year. The students must maintain a 3.25 GPA to keep the honor. For anyone interested in the NWOSU Scholarship Foundation, visit nwosu.edu/scholarships. The Northwestern Oklahoma State University Institute for Citizenship Studies and Department of Social Sciences will present the annual Constitution Day event for 2016 on September 13th at 7 p.m. This year's topic will be George Mason, the man who would not sign. The program will be held in the Education Center, Room 109. For more information, contact Dr. Aaron Mason, Professor of Political Science in Northwestern's Department of Social Sciences at 580-327-8522 or email Mason at nwosu.edu.
With football season starting last week, Northwestern students were eager to rally around the Rangers for the first football game. Take a look.
Ranger Rally is an event put on by the SGA, the Student Government Association. We come out, it's like a pep rally for that first game of the year every year. We take a look at all the teams that are going to be out here, the student body's going to be out here. Everybody comes through, we introduce the coaches, we introduce the president, let everybody get kind of acquainted, and then after that, play some games, hang out, and beat them. Everybody goes home. Everybody goes home a happy Ranger.
SGA gave out free t-shirts for the first 250 students in line, gave out free hot dogs, and had numerous prizes for this year's Ranger Rally event.
That's going to do it for us this week. Thank you for joining us.
Tune in next week.